Namaskar to all respected judges and to all the viewers who are watching me now. My name is Millie Ruth, contestant number 237, daughter of Sri Millie Takko and Srimati Millie Renu, studying at Government Higher Secondary School Raga in 11th standard. I belong to Raga Town Baptist Church, Kamla District, State Arunachal Pradesh, and here I am to deliver my short speech on the topic that I have chosen, the role of Christian youth in society. So kindly do like and share and also subscribe and ring the bell icon. So let's start. So traditionally, youth is a small grown-up baby born from his or her mother's womb by the blessings of God. As a young believer of Christ, they can do anything and everything that they want. And if they are encouraged well enough to participate in the life of the church when they are young, they will continue to do it in their adulthood. They can play music, lead songs, and be a helping hand for others. So here we are going to talk about the role of Christian youths in the society. First and foremost, as a Christian youth, one must know that they should know something about the Bible, so that when people question us what is the Bible, then we could proudly answer them that the Bible is the holy book of Christian and is the words of God Jesus Christ. Youth must remember that it's not just about going to church or reading the Bible. We can make a difference by performing some various activities in the church. Like in church, we can provide some fresh perspective on things. Some elder people might be too confused or stuck at some issues at the meeting or in some discussions. So at that very time, what can you do is that you can offer their own views or ideas on the situation from which everyone can get benefit. Not only this, during celebrations like Christmas and in big functions, there is a main role for the youth to take all over in church. As young muscles work better than adults and have amazing ideas, they are given the decoration task and other tasks where youths are directed by the adults. And if we see, most of the duties are given to the youth departments of particular church, as adults have good expectations on them. They say that the youths are the backbone of the church. But first of all, youth should be the backbone of youth itself. Helping one in one's life helps us to get ready for our future. For we know that the backbones are also formed by the unity of other small bones, and then unity in youth can support the church and in each and every cause. For human beings are mortal, Ecclesiastes chapter 1 verse 4 says, generation comes and generation goes, and between that ongoing generation, people set an example for their youngster in such a way to show them the right path to go and make them look, learn, and live into it. While our ancestors were the future of yesterday, we are the future of today, and our upcoming generations will be the future of tomorrow. So, through this point to all my youth friends, let us set an example for our youngster in such a way that whatever we do in our life, that should reflect the goodness of God. How we clean our church, let's also clean our hearts. Even if someone hurt us so badly, we should be able to forgive them, as these all are the qualities that a Christian youth must have. Let's show a way for those who are lost, confused, scared, or hurt. Let's be positive-minded and encourage our brothers and sisters. Along with going to church, let's also concentrate on our studies, for we are the future of our parents. Let's love our environment and our animals, because God created all of them for us. And if possible, we should thank and worship them, so that through our good deeds, when we go out from this world, we could enter another world, the gate of glory, and thereafter we shall have an everlasting eternal life. Amen.